testing this morning for many students, and then with our band concert at the end of the day, we knew that that was just not enough time for you to get to all your classes. And so we scheduled this very special schedule to give you some different things to do today instead of class. So I want to thank your teachers for being so flexible today and allowing us to have some special activities and enjoy this beautiful day at the end of the year. And now we're going to finish the day. We're going to finish the day by supporting our band students in their very last concert. So please give them your very best attention, and you can do that by being a really kind listener in that you don't whisper during the concert so they can do their best thinking. And I'm speaking to band students as well, because sometimes after you perform and you're all relaxed, then you like talk a little bit about how it went. But we're gonna ask you today to not do that at all and to be very silent. To be very silent today during the concert and to acknowledge them at the end of their performance just by showing your support and appreciation for all their hard work. I think you're really going to enjoy the concert today. They did a lot of hard work and it is great. And with that, we'll begin.
Good afternoon, and tomorrow we wait for this all year to be able to present our concert to you right here in the month of May. We enjoyed the orchestra concert. We hope you enjoy our concert, and you're going to also get a chance to enjoy the choir next week. We're going to get started. We have a lot of music for you, a lot of different types of music for you, and we're going to start off with a Spanish march featuring our trumpets called Coronado.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. The second one we're going to do is an overture, and you may not know this gentleman. His name's James Swearingen, who wrote this piece, but he is a staff writer for the Ohio State Marching Band. And we love our technology so much, so I'm going to give you a little bit of an assignment tonight. And if you go onto YouTube later on tonight and type in Ohio State Marching Band, you will see some of the most amazing designs put on a football field by a marching band, to the point where they have one show where they actually outline the figure of Superman, and he flies to the top of this building. This is a formation that the band does for their halftime show. The gentleman that writes for them is the one who wrote this piece of music. It's called Baywood Overture.
Thank you.
Let me take a minute and recognize two students who were at Elementary Honors Band, and that was at South Fayette High School about 2 weeks ago. Little did we know that our next principal is coming from South Fayette, and I actually had a chance to hear him speak. But these two students were at that festival, and I want to recognize them. First, Lauren Truitt on clarinet, and also Evan Greenberg on the French horn. A round of applause for them. They had a unique experience that many people don't have. And the gentleman who was conducting, the guest conductor, was also an internationally known composer. And he writes music of all the way from beginning band all the way to colleges, universities, and symphony orchestras. And he's a pretty well-known composer in the realm. His name is Brian Balmages, and I've done many of his pieces. One of my favorites is called Proudly We Hail. In any event, we're gonna continue, change styles a little bit. Many of these students are gonna be eligible to be in jazz band next year, so I give them experience playing a jazz piece. So you're gonna hear a concert band act like a jazz band. This is called Cruise Control. We have one more for you, and I don't think there's anybody that doesn't like the movies Despicable Me. And out of those movies came a very popular song, and very pleasing to me, it's a positive song. And we need more of those positive messages. And if you are a fan of shows like The Voice and watch the competitiveness, you see judges. And the gentleman that wrote this song was one of the judges on The Voice not too long ago. This is probably one of their favorite songs. It's one of my favorite that sixth grade's doing by Pharrell Williams. This is Happy. Thank you. Give us a few minutes. We're going to have 7th and 8th grade up on stage.
Thank you.
While they're getting situated, prepared for their first song, let me say thank you to Mrs. Slowick and Mrs. Miller for displaying all your wonderful artwork around concert time. It really is a pleasure to go out and look at all the wonderful artwork and your hard work at creating all of this. So thank you to Mrs. Slowick and also Mrs. Miller. This is the 7th and 8th grade band, and there are approximately 65 on stage, and you're going to hear a pretty wide range of selections today. We're going to try to do all five of the ones that we have planned. The first one is one of my favorites that I've conducted many times going back the years of my teaching career, called Oxford Point. It has a very catchy melody and rhythm to it, but it also has a very beautiful slow section that features our flutes and oboes. Oxford Point.
Thank you.
Trumpet Solo in the Middle by Scott Malapa. The next song is a patriotic piece that we like to do one every concert. This is called Let Freedom Ring. It is a combination of America the Beautiful, America, and You're a Grand Old Flag. And what's unique about this is America, or My Country, Tis of Thee, is usually in three beats to a measure, and this composer has done it in four to make it a little bit of a twist. Turned out to be one of their favorites, and I say one because they have many out of the five, but it was unexpected. And the title of the piece is called Rhythmata, and the composer has this written in his notes about this piece. His goal was to emphasize rhythm as the main thematic material. Melodies are not emphasized, but stated only by solos in the flute, trumpet, and baritone. The best description would be a rhythmic etude for band. This is unlike probably anything you've heard. And you're going to hear very short solos by Cameron Frencho on the flute, Scott Malapa on trumpet, and Owen Prem on the baritone. Plus, you're going to hear a lot of interesting percussion sounds because they are an integral part of this, being that it is a rhythm piece, Rhythmata.
Thank you.
The next piece probably doesn't need an introduction, so I'm not going to introduce it. You're going to recognize it within the first four measures. But I'll give you a hint. Something's happening on Friday.
Given up on the Star Wars franchise. No one's just gonna be that good.
Recognize the students on stage who were in Honors Band representing 7th and 8th grade. At PMEA Honors Band, let's see if I can remember all of these people. It was Emily Grzynski and Justina Wang and Aiden Seuss. And then also at AV Honors Band, let's see, Emily can stay standing. It was Nathan. And Nathan Lamb, Scott Nalepa, Austin Avanko, Alex McBriar, Ben Pison, and Owen Prem. Honors Band is a considerable amount of time because you're there all day Friday and pretty much all day on a Saturday. If you're an AV Honors Band, it's two full days plus an evening, but it's quite an honor to be around people that are selected sometimes from 60 different school districts. The last piece we're going to do is a medley of older music that most of the staff's going to know, and I think many of you are going to know. Thank goodness back in the 60s we had a visionary, and that visionary was Berry Gordy. And if you don't know who Berry Gordy was, or is, Berry Gordy was the one who founded Motown. And he brought to us people like Michael Jackson and Stevie Wonder. And he also brought this group that we are featuring four selections from. And four of their big hits were called Papa Was a Rolling Stone, My Girl, Ain't Too Proud to Beg, and Get Ready. And of course, I'm talking about The Temptations. In a very quick change, we're going to close the curtain. And while they are setting up for jazz band, the woodwind ensemble is going to come down in front and play one song for you in between. So be real patient, be quiet, because we're going to get going right away.
Thank you.
This is the last group that you're going to hear today, and they're going to play a couple numbers for you. This is the Jazz Ensemble. They've been very busy. They're also continuing to be busy because on Wednesday, June 6th, they're going to travel to three elementary schools and play three different concerts, or three concerts in one day. And I know they look forward to that. But we're going to get on with some music. This first one is a blues tune. It's kind of in tribute to Count Basie. And Count Basie had one of the most famous big bands in all of jazz. And this is appropriately entitled Filling In for the Count. Coleman Walsh is going to be playing the part of Count Basie, playing some piano fills. And you're going to hear improvised solos by Austin Evanko on trumpet, Hunter Badamo on alto sax, and Scott Nalepa on the trumpet. Filling In for the Count.
Thank you.
thank you. I want to just convey to you the three solos that came up here. An improvised solo is something you make up right here on the spot. And that's something they've been working on all year, being able to create their own solos, pick their own notes, pick their own rhythms, their own ideas. And that's something, if you think about it, how would you feel standing up in front of 400 or 500 people and not knowing exactly what to play, no music? You're creating it. And I'm really proud of them because we had quite a battle as to who gets the solos, and that's what they did. They battled it out, who was the best soloist, and that's how they got selected. And there is another song that we're going to do in the evening program just like that. We're going to do something a little different with the jazz man. We've rarely done a ballad, and this next one goes back to 1969 with a band called the Classics Four. And the song is called Traces. Traces is a really beautiful melody. If you've ever heard the song or you want to check it out, really beautiful song. And it's arranged by former Pittsburgher Sammy Nestico, who's in his 90s and still writing. And I love doing his music. This features Aiden Seuss on the tenor sax, Traces. Oh, and I also want to make mention behind me, Braden Kushner is a trumpet player in seventh grade. He's going to be playing drums on a tune here coming up, but he learned to play mallet and the vibes just for this song. Thank you. Folks, I think we have time maybe for one more, but let me first of all thank all of the students in the band program, 6th, 7th, and 8th grade, how hard you've worked this year. 6th grade, you have such a mature sound in such a very short period of time. 7th and 8th graders, you've really worked hard. Our activity rehearsals have been really outstanding, and it's displayed in your playing. Let me take also a minute to acknowledge my colleagues, Mrs. Davis, but also our retiring music teachers, Ms. Bauer and Mr. Whistler. A round of applause for them, please. A real pleasure to have a music department with those folks in. And before I also forget, I want to thank the teachers for understanding with the students coming down for activity period and all the things that all of you are involved with. Maybe I ought to stand like this. And also to thank the administration for their support, and thank Dr. Stark for her years here at IMS and her support of you folks, as well as everybody here. We're going to close with another Count Basie tune. And the teachers, I will mention this to you. You will probably, maybe you might remember this from a movie back in the 70s. If you don't, I'll talk to you later, let you know what movie it was in. But a very well-known movie, one of the funniest movies you'll ever see, but I'll talk to the teachers about that later. This is called April in Paris.